28th of July 2017.
Okay, this is a Maltese male, not neutered, 5 years old. It comes in with a complaint that the whole skin, the neck below, and the paws are all the four paws, and then below the body is full of scales and hair, the hair loss and inflammation. Now these are a lot of crustiness, and then you will notice the ears also, that ear edges, crustiness, the right ear, and then the left ear. Okay, so these are the main signs. And then we see the back, the tail, below the tail, the tail also affected. You can see the whole tail is infected. But the thing, you can see the body is good. So this shows that the skin disease has not spread to the body. How long is this skin disease? About 4 months?
4 months.
Four months. Or more than that?
It was just started on the neck first, then after that the legs, everything.
Okay, according to the owner, it started from the neck, he's been scratching the neck. And then you see the eyes also. Now I have to take out the muzzle so that I can see the face. Okay. Come, so I won't touch his face because it's angry, because I see the face also affected. So this is a case of a generalized skin disease, we call it. So according to the owner, it starts from the neck. Most likely it starts from the face. They start from the eyes, rubbing the eyes? The neck. Ears? Scratching the ears?
I saw this from the neck first.
Okay. So at the first diagnosis, if the body was okay, the legs okay at that time?
Yes.
So it's very important to know the history. So you know the history. So from what I can see is if you start from the neck, and then you can see the crustiness here there on the ears. You did see the ear crustiness?
No, I didn't.
Maybe you didn't see. So did you apply some cream or something on the body?
No.
So it didn't. So it was treated by one vet 2 times, 4 months ago, but it didn't respond. Okay, now we can see around the eyes. You can see it's rubbing around the eyes.
Definitely.
Okay. So overall, this case is most likely 2 possibilities. One is of course allergies to food, shampoo or any other things, like dog treats or even the environment. Then the second possibility is, we call it the mites. The mites are scabies. And the scabies mites always shows signs of crustiness. Like a lot of crusty dendrum. And according to the owner, it spreads from here to the neck. It spreads down. And scabies, like in rabbits, they always happen in the distal areas. They don't happen to the body. At the beginning, the body is okay, because the distal areas, like the paws and the ears, they are cooler. So and the face also, so the scabies mites always goes to these areas and multiply, and then become crusty. So it's one possibility, scabies. Then the other possibility, of course, it is a ringworm or bacteria and yeast, but. So we'll do the test now. Where you hold it down? You hold it. I will do the test to check for ringworm. You hold first. Okay. So what I do is, okay. There are a few things to do.
You gotta put the muzzle first.
I'll put the muzzle first. Okay. If I see also.
Yeah, it gets angry when I breathe.
That's painful. Yeah. Okay, come, relax.
Okay.
Hold first.
Okay. Ronnie.
Come. Just
Ronnie.
Okay, relax. Quite good, huh? So I'm going to do the skin test. Now skin scrapings, normally we scrape the ears for the mites or scabies. We scrape here, use a blade, and it's crushed, and it's quite painful. And I'll do the ordinary first, get the crust out.
Okay.
And then I put on the tape, on the cellophane tape, and then I check the microscope first. In the first one, this is to check for mites, and we'll see how it goes. Now, of course, normally they are under the skin, so you might not be able to see. But if there's too many, then you can see them. And the other thing I check is for the ringworm on the hair. Ringworm will give you these scales, so these scaly things. Now from the microscope, quick examination of the crust. They don't seem to have any scabies mites because I haven't done any scraping. But there's ringworm, there's a fungus. And fungus can be very itchy. So there's one possibility. Fungus is one of them. So now I will do this ultraviolet light to check. Now if there's fungus, it will shine. Is it ready? Can you just put the dog upside down? Just like hold upside down. 1, 2, 3. And then I hold on to your armpit. Now just hold on. Just hold like that.
Hold armpit.
So if there is a fungus, the skin will glow. It will have very fluorescent, we call it, it glows. Normal skin wouldn't glow. Glow means shiny. Like, you see, fungus, the skin is shiny. You see, so it's full of fungus. The whole body is full of fungus. Normal skin, you can see here, okay, come here. See, normal skin. Normal skin doesn't glow, there, you see. Normal skin and hair, you see. Although it does grow a bit because it's already spread. But those very bad ones, I see. So that's the reason why you can't solve the problem, because it's spreading. Even the tail also. The tail also has got it. The tail is full of fluorescent. So the 99% is ringworm. Okay, you can do a blood test.